All right, welcome back. Here's another super exciting After Effects tutorial. This time we're animating this sort of 3D scene where we've got a couple different layers. We've got a background, and we're moving through using a 3D camera here in After Effects. So we're going to see how to do that. If you don't have any images, I'll put a link down in the description for this PSD file. But you could easily just Google or create something in Photoshop, or just drag in some transparent or transparent files or whatever. And as long as you have a couple of things to work with, that will make it easy. Right-click in the project panel here, select Import File, and we select our Photoshop file, and I'm going to select Composition, Retain Layer Sizes. This way, I've got a composition ready to go just as I set it up in Photoshop. Again, if you're just importing a bunch of images, you'll have to create a new composition and just drop them in there. So once you have all of those images, or you have this file open, and we've got a basic composition here in After Effects, mine has these guides on it, and I don't want to look at those. So I'm going to turn those off so they're not in my way. So here we have this flat image right now, and we've got a couple different layers. We can click and drag them around the scene, and you know, it's kind of like color forms. I don't know if you ever, anybody remember color forms? Those were great. I'm gonna select all these layers, and I'm gonna turn on this 3D box here. This will turn each of these layers, everything selected, into a 3D layer. If you don't have these columns here, if something's not showing up, just go down here and turn them on here in this, these little icons to expand or collapse those additional columns. I'm also going to add, go up to Layer, New Camera. I'm going to add a camera here. So now I've got a layer and a camera layer and several image layers. And I'm going to organize these so that they're in sort of a 3D space. Now, if I select the back layer, that's the sky here. You see, I can move this around. It's a sky layer. I hit P to open up position, and I can adjust the position right here. A lot of different ways to do the same thing. Hit Control Z to go back. This is my up and down, left and right, horizontal, vertical, and then this last one here with that double zero, this adjusts Z space. So it goes back. When I drag this up, it goes back. If I bring it forward, look, it comes in front of everything else because everything's in 3D. So I'm gonna set this to like 5,000. Looks like it's just getting smaller. You might say that, but you'd be wrong because it's actually going back in Z space. Okay, so what I have to do is I have to drag to make this large again, but I'll hold down shift so it keeps it the same size. It constrains the proportions. That's the proper terminology. So now the sky is really far back. And to show you what we're doing here, I could take this camera that we just added, and I could move it around by hitting the camera controls. So hit C, and that'll give me the camera controls. And see what's happening here is, as we turn, right, and I'll zoom out a little, hit C a few more times, and I'm zooming out. And then hit C again. I've got this orbit tool. And look what's happening. The background is way back there, and my characters are up front. So I'm going to hit Control Z a few times to get back to where I was, because I don't necessarily want that. In fact, what you can do is this little panel or box or whatever this is, this little pop-up here, this allows you to select different cameras to look at. So right now we're looking at the active camera. That's the one right here. But let's say I want to use just something to just move around and look at. I can hit custom view one or two, whatever they are, custom view one. And look, now we have a different view. And if I hit C, that's the camera tool. Look, I can kind of spin around and it shows me not only my layers, but also where this camera is. So this is a super handy way to look at your scene from the side. In fact, if you hit custom view again and you hit right, it shows you exactly what it looks like from the right. Here's that layer, and if I zoom out, this line here is that far back sky layer. Just going in and out with the scroll wheel. I could also go top view. So this is a top down view. Scroll back and look, camera's here, really far away. Camera, and then there's the other layers, and there's that background layer. Go back over here, go back to active camera. Scroll back in, everything's back to normal. Nice and neat. Okay, so now I'm gonna move some more of these layers around. I'm gonna hit V. I noticed that I didn't think that sky was far away enough, so maybe I'll turn it up to like 6,500, right? And then gonna have to make it big again. I can always hit scale, S for scale. and drag it with the little number controls here. So I've got that. That's probably far away enough. I want these buildings really, really far away also. Right now they're kind of small, but undo. I'm going to hit P, and I'm going to push those way back as well. In fact, I'll make those 3,000 pixels away, right? Again, I'm going to hold down Shift and drag this so that they're large. And now they're kind of way back there. And these two guys, the goon squad here, we can arrange them any way we want. We can put this guy right here, and we could put goon one over here. It's easier to select them down here in the layer list. And then, let's see, let's push this guy back. I'm gonna hit P, and I'll push him back. Look at this, now he's behind this floor layer. And here's something that you'll notice. This is different, like if you're used to Photoshop, the layer order, whatever's on top usually will be displayed on top. But when you're working with 3D cameras, that kind of goes out the window, so that when you push something back, it is further in 3D space. Again, if we hit our right view, we'll see there's our goon right there, zoom out. Goon one, there's the camera, that little dot. There's the buildings, there's this. If you want to see something a little bit more, a little bit easier to understand, let's go to custom view and hit C to get our camera tool. And look, now we can see kind of where our guys are arranged. You know, what we can do also is we can even arrange things in this window. I'll hit the ground layer, I'll hit P, and I can move it back. Let's say I want that ground layer way back there. You could arrange things in this view, and then this way, you get a really good sense of how far away they are. Hit the active camera, go back, check what it looks like. It looks weird, so I'm gonna hit V, and I'm gonna just scale this up. Make it as big as I want. I can even, you know, this is just a ground layer. I can make it flat too. So I'll put the ground back there. This guy's here. He's behind the big goon. And another way I can move things around here is I can grab these little handles here. If I grab the Z space handle, I'm moving him forward and backward in space. If I look at my custom view again, I can grab those handles. Now I can really get a sense of how far away they are. So if this helps you work, hitting C to look at it, spin around, if this helps you work to see things and get a sense of the layout, then this is a great way to work. This is like the bulk of this tutorial. I mean, you could really have fun from this point on. I'm really just gonna finish this out, but I bet you could just take it and run with this here. I'm gonna go back to my active camera. Oh, this is, you'll wanna, wait, if you haven't left already, stick around for this. This is fun. So the camera here, let's do this. I like to keyframe the camera motion. So now you'll really get a sense. This is why we're doing this. Otherwise, it's just a picture, right? We're working with video here. So I'm gonna keyframe these two first values right here, and it generates keyframes right there in the layer, in the timeline panel. I'm gonna move up, this thing's a minute long also. I do this every time, it's always a minute. I gotta change that. So we'll drag that down to maybe about 7 or 8 seconds, right click, trim comp to work area. So it starts here, and then if I hit my camera tool by hitting C, and if you look at the icon, the cursor icon, whatever you call it, it's changed. Every time I hit C, it changes. This is the zoom in out tool, undo. Hit C again, this is the orbit around tool. I could move it around here, undo. If I hit C again, I get this arrow tool, and this is side to side. So that's how that camera tool works. Hit undo. So again, there's no keyframe. You shouldn't have anything generated yet. I have a starting keyframe, and then I'm gonna wanna really zoom in. Let's say this is a story about this guy here. So we're gonna zoom in, kinda close, and then I'm gonna hit the camera tool again because it zoomed in on his fist. So let's hit the camera tool so we kinda move up and maybe focus a little bit more on his face, right? Now we'll go back to the beginning, hit play, and we'll see how that moves. That's pretty quick. Maybe you want that. I'm gonna take these keyframes, drag them out to about 5 seconds, bring it back to the beginning, hit space bar to play. And now we've got this, and you see it looks kind of 3D. It looks like we're moving through with an actual camera. And that's literally what's happening. If you hit the custom view and orbit over to look at this. Watch what happens now. And I hit play. Now, oh, it doesn't show us. Well, you're going to have to just imagine that we're hitting play. But if I drag the cursor here in the timeline, you see the kit showing the camera's literally moving in. Let's go back to my active camera, hit play. So this is great. It moves in, moves past the big guy here, and it moves right into this guy. And when it stops, here's what I like to do. Select those two, hit F9. That's the hot key for easy ease. So now instead of a hard stop, it just kind of comes to a smoother stop. You can adjust that, but that's not what this tutorial is about, so we're not going to spend time on that. What we will do is add a few more details. So select all my layers, close them up to keep them clean. And this ground right here is great. I'm gonna hit V to go to my select tool. And I'm gonna hit the ground and Control D to duplicate it. That creates another ground layer. And with this one, I'm gonna take the handle and I'm gonna drag this one forward. But look at this, I don't want it to be in between or in front. I want it to be kind of right there. And I want it to look like it's more of a different, like there's a whole lot of ground here. In fact, if I right click on that, transform and flip horizontal, that'll just flip it the opposite, like it mirrors. You know, now it looks like it's a different thing and it's a little bit forward in Z space. So it looks like we've got some ground on there, like a couple layers of ground depth. I mean, you could do several of those. I could duplicate that again, ground three. This one I could bring forward even a little bit more. Maybe for this one, I could adjust the size right here. I could squash it down so it looks a little different. Maybe do that, right? Or I could hit R, maybe adjust the rotation just a little bit here so it looks a little bit like actual nature. Okay, I'm going to stop messing with this stuff, but here we go. Oh, that one seems to be in front of our friend here. So let's push it back. Oh, we got to get it right in between. Oh, here's something to notice. If you see that your layers, I'm going to hit C again. You see how these layers are crossed there? That's going to cause problems. So once you start messing with things in 3D, you'll see these layers, tough to see with our guy in there. Let's turn him off. But if you see these two layers are crossing in front of each other, that's going to look really weird because they're kind of intersecting. So I'll go back to my active camera. In fact, let's just fix that by pushing this layer back, hit position, push him back just a little bit. And look at that. Everything kind of smooths out. I'll put that back there. Let's put the other one, maybe make it a little bigger. That's good. How's our goons looking? They look good. Okay, so here's our 3D push. We have a couple ground layers. What are some other things we can do? Glad you asked. All right, select all, close these layers down. Maybe I want to blur the background a little bit. So I could always put a little blur on there. I mean, it's After Effects. There's tons of built-in things you can add. You could put, maybe you want to put in a glow on some of these things. Maybe you want to make some of the buildings glow a little bit. Maybe you want to add some fire layers in there, smoke, things like that. I'm going to put just a little bit of blur on the background so it looks like it's kind of far away. And another thing is you can blur. If I take this goon right here and as the camera moves past, sometimes what I'll do is I'll put sort of a camera blur and I'll keyframe it so he goes almost like out of focus. Another way we could do that is with the camera itself. If I double click on the camera and if I adjust the camera and if I change the f-stop to like 1.3, let's see. Then you see we have a little bit of a blur on our character here in the foreground, and you can really adjust this camera so it's very similar. If you know some things about cameras and how they work, you can really get this guy to blur. You can work on a nice shallow depth of field. I almost always just create my own because I feel like it gives me a little bit more control. So I will keyframe his blurriness, hit U to open up all the expressions. And I'll just have him start to get blurry right here and then get really blurry as we go past. So two different ways to do the same thing. So here's our character. He gets a little blurry here. Last thing we're going to do just for fun, since we've got a bunch of 3D layers, why not add in a 3D light? So go to Layer, New, Light, and you can choose any number of different lights. I usually almost always use a spotlight unless I'm doing something special, but the spotlight will just generate this spotlight. Again, if I go to my custom view, I see this is great. This is where custom view is really going to come in handy, because you can adjust your light here, and by moving the camera around, you'll really see what's being lit up. I'm going to go back to my active camera, so maybe it's sort of dusk or nighttime. So with the light here, we've added another level of detail. We could certainly keyframe this light. We could have it maybe zoom in or zoom out. Maybe we put it right about here, and we keyframe the position of the light so that it kind of opens up. Maybe it gets darker. Look at that. Light moves past the character, and we have something kind of like this. Again, have fun, play around, use the lights. You've got enough to get started. Now go ahead and have fun. You can download the layers here, and that's it for this one.